Switching gears now, the baseball player and the Blue Room bagged the top awards at this year's Cinemalaya Philippine Independent Film Festival. Carlo Obispo's The Baseball Player, which tells the story of a Moro child soldier aspiring to become a baseball player in the time of war, won Best Film, Best Screenplay, and Best Editing. Maan Asuncion Bangalan, meanwhile, took home the Best Director Award for Blue Room, a film about young musicians who are arrested for drug possession. It also won 5 titles, including Best Cinematography and the Special Jury Award. Joining us now on the show are the two winning directors, Carlo Obispo and Maan Asuncion Bangalan. Good morning, Maan. Good morning, Carlo. Thank you for being on the show.
Good morning.
All right, so first off, allow me to congratulate you both and your teams, of course, for taking home top awards at this year's Cinemalaya Festival. Carlo, let's start with you. This is your third year, na, no? How does the feeling compare to the previous years?
Masaya kasi the first time I joined Cinemalaya kasi hindi ako nanalo.
Understandable.
This is my first time to bag Best Film Award and I'm just so happy and grateful. It's so magical eh. So, ayun, hanggang ngayon, hindi pa masyadong nagsisink in sa akin. Sobrang saya lang.
And yung ikaw, Maan, this is your first year naman. How does it feel? How did it feel bagging all these awards?
As I've mentioned before, that I feel so ecstatic and at the same time, because I really never thought that we're gonna get this awards, especially special jury and best director, since it's my first time joining Cinemalaya.
Mm-hmm. What's the special jury award, if you can indulge us?
I'm not really exactly sure what special jury, but according to my co-producer, it's, I think, the judges itself, the juror or the jury who chose Blue Room, that's why it's special jury.
So there's a special award giving body for
That's right. So I'm not really sure if I explained it that well.
All right, so can you both tell us what your respective films are about, as well as the inspirations, of course, behind it? Carlo, let's start with The Baseball Player.
Nikki, when I decided to become a filmmaker, so I asked myself, no, kung ano yung mga, like what sort of stories I would want to tell, and I decided to make films about Filipino children, those stories that are not usually tackled in mainstream cinema. So when I was in college, kasi may all-out war na nangyari, the sa so nung naghanap ako in 2016, I decided to take a closer look at the conflicts in Mindanao. So I started developing my script. So it's most of my films so far tackle Filipino children's stories.
Yeah. So you actually lived through war, kaya nakaka-relate ka dun sa story that you came up with. And for Maan, tell us about the Blue Room synopsis and inspirations behind your crafting of the story like that.
Oh, okay. Let's start with the synopsis. Short synopsis. It's a rock band composed of privileged teenagers who are caught due to drug possession, and they are brought to VIP room called Blue Room. That's where they're gonna have a difficult decision between buying their freedom and standing up for what they believe in. So the inspiration, same as with Carlo, it's inspired by true events, because in 2010, when I had my workshop under Sir Bing Lau called Found Story, we are required to look for a true story. And fortunately, I have a friend who knows this band. So, so I wrote this, and then unfortunately, it didn't make it in 2010 Cinemalaya. And in 2018, when I had my workshop under Sir Ricky Lee, the concept that I was writing, or what which I submitted to Sir Ricky, for some reason, I got stuck up and I can't finish it. So I thought of, why not continuing or finishing Blue Room? So I told Sir Ricky that I'm changing the story that I submitted. So the rest is history.
That's why these stories are so poignant, because they're grounded on three life events that you have also been connected to in person. Now, Carly, you've since said na kailangan nating magkwento ng mga totoo, makabuluhan, at makakapagpabago ng ating pagtingin sa lipunan, di ba? So why so? What are the biggest challenges of touching on these stories, the poignant?
Yeah, Nikki. Nasabi ko yan, no? Kasi like right now, making films is very challenging. Aside from pandemic kasi, nagkakalat din ng mga fake news, mga irresponsible storytelling. So, that's why I mentioned na being filmmakers, we really have to be more responsible. Gumawa tayo ng mga makabuluhan na hindi mga pelikula na may pinoprotektahang individuals or family, mga kanilang mga makasariling interes. That's why I said that. That's why kami ni Maan, no, yung mga stories namin are grounded on true events. Kasi ito yung mga kasi yung Sinimalaya, no? Mas pinapakita namin yung mga kwento na hindi natin inaasahan na ipapakita ng mga major networks. So, yun, ang challenging lang kasi naman doon, unang-una, mahirap kumuha ng funding kasi hindi alternative kasi siya, no? Hindi siya yung mga tipo ng pelikula na mga genre or mga nakasanayan na pinupuntahan sa sinihan, ganun. So hindi siya ganun kadaling hanapan ng mga supporters or fundings or even audience. Medyo challenging siya.
Kudos to you both, no, for finding storylines na kakaiba pa rin in a time when sunod-sunod lang ang paglabas ng movies, diba? And Maan, for you, what role does cinema play in shedding light on the grim realities some of us are dealing with now? Case in point, the Mindanao conflict for the baseball player, tapos the drug war and the drug problem for the blue.
Well, actually, Sinimalaya is playing an important role to us filmmakers, especially for the beginners like me, especially if we have something to say, especially if we want to say the truth that's really going on around us. So, yun, because yun nga, no censorship and all. So, we can say whatever we want to say because yun nga, as a filmmaker, it's our responsibility to tell the truth. So, parang yung sinabi nga ni Carlo na parang dahil meron mga censorship and then may spread, may mga fake news all over. So parang here, we can, parang pwede namin sabihin kung ano yung talagang totoo at yung dapat malaman ng audience, yun.
And are you also eyeing for these films to be shown to festivals abroad? Where else can we view these films now that Sinimalaya has passed? Let's go with you first, Carlo.
Yung Sinimalaya Film Festival is still ongoing until October. Mm-hmm. So they're gonna be going around the country, like Iloilo. They have to follow Sinimalaya page kasi they'll update naman the schedule.
Mm-hmm. And, all right.
Yeah, for the film festivals abroad, we're still on our way there.
Anything to add, Maan?
Yun, so far, I agree with Carlo. Kasi right now, parang finalize pa what regions where to screen our films. And but definitely there's gonna be an online streaming of all Sinimalaya finalists, feature length and short films, I guess.
All right, on that note, thank you so much for joining us. You too, Maan and Carlo, you stay safe. More power to you guys and what you do.
Thank you, Nikki.
Thank you.